الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. ما شاء الله, as the days of Dhul Hijjah continue to pass before our eyes, let us make an opportunity to take the most advantage of these days by increasing in our good deeds. And while, mashallah, we've mentioned such beautiful acts as fasting in the days of Dhul Hijjah, as doing extra sadaqah and giving, discharging your udhiya, your sacrifice and qurbani, praying extra salah, staying up for tahajjud, such beautiful acts, let's take a step a little bit more practically, perhaps, for many of us in the community, and use this time the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has advised us in these days of the Ashhur al-Hurum, in the days of the sacred months, to guard our obligatory acts. This is where we should be starting. We look to fulfill that which is obligatory before that which is voluntary. That we draw closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that which Allah has made fard upon us. So for meaning that, our five times daily salah is where we should start. That if we are going to make any concerted and concentrated effort in this blessed month, that let it be that we fulfill our obligation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that which Allah has made fard upon us, beginning with our five salah, Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, and Isha, guarding those times and making sure that we pray our salah on time, not making excuses or allowing things to distract us, because this is where the believer needs to start. So much has been said in the sunnah as far as the blessings and the virtues of salah, a few of which we'll mention here today, just so that we can use that as a motivation to get ourselves out of our lackadaisical lifestyle, or perhaps it's a means of the environment in which we're in. Whatever the case, whatever excuse we have for not praying, Allah has made it obligatory upon us. That should be enough. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us that salah is your means of personal communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning, if you have any issues going on in your life, if you have any problems that are challenging you, if you have anything that is making you feel uncomfortable, you go straight to the source. Everything is from Allah and everything will return to Allah. So you talk to Allah through your salah. Prayer is what is going to be the first thing looked at on the Day of Judgment. If we have the sense of belief that we will be held accountable for our deeds on the Day of Judgment, salah is the first thing that is looked at by the malaika. And the angels will open up your book of deeds and they will see the salah. And if your salah is intact, then you will move forward with your questioning. And if your salah is not intact, then you basically will have to be, the malaika, it's mentioned in the hadith, will look through the books and see if there are any nafil prayers that could perhaps make up for our decline in our fard salah and our obligatory prayers and services. Then if that is not there, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send us to the back of the line, and therein begins a very arduous and difficult journey. So that is number two. Another reason for why we would pray is that this is literally our identity. Islam is built upon five pillars. And so in this month of Dhul Hijjah, in the sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to us, is we guard that which is obligatory upon us. And for that, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us consistent and regular in our salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to always pray our salah on its prescribed time. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to perfect our prayer with khushu', with true understanding and humility, as we stand in front of our Lord and pour out our hearts to the only one who will listen and do anything about it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our salah. Allahumma ameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabi ajma'in.